Hey guys, it's UK's Rob P. Today I'm going to do something a little bit different on the channel. I'm going to be reviewing a new ship I've just bought. Okay, so the ship that I have just got is the nicor bio-warship. Let's have a quick look through all the settings on it. Okay, so this is what I have just bought. It does come with these fitted to it, the fluidic antiproton dual beams, the antiproton dual cannons, the dual heavy cannons, and three antiproton beams at the back. For now, until I can afford some upgrades for them or some better ones off the exchange, I have actually updated them to the Advanced Fleet Antiproton Dual Cannons, the Advanced Fleet Antiproton Dual Heavy Cannons, and the Herald Antiproton Dual Beam, and the Fleet Antiproton Dual Bank as well as two antiproton beam arrays in the back. Just realised that that's the wrong one. I bought that one by mistake last time, that's the one I've actually got. I've actually got an accuracy bonus on that one. As well as, I haven't actually got any valid fuel left at the minute, so I couldn't get any more turrets. So I've got the fluidic antiproton turrets in the back, two of them. I'm also running the red matter capacitor, which gives you a plus 25 all power level for 20 seconds, a battery energy amplifier. And also a battery hull patch, which gives you 2000 hit points and a 20% in maximum hit points for 10 seconds on your ship. I'm also running the Iconian Resistance Resilient Shield Array. At the minute, I've just got one of them. I am in the process of changing the Nicari to Iconian for this, just basically for the shield heals. Obviously, if I get all my set, I'll have plus 33 damage for 30 seconds, plus 20 max hull, and plus 10 for me fleet speed. At the minute, I'm running the Terran Task Force Quantum Capacitor at Epic. My consoles I'm running the Fluidic Energy Focuser Array, which gives you a big antiproton damage on there. I'm also running the Universal Disability Module from the Omega Rep, basically just for the crit chance, crit severity, and the regen on there. As well as, that's me engineering. It's not that, as well as that two engineering slots. You don't get very much to be able to put in there. I'm also running the bioneural infusion circuit, which again, for the hull capacity and the crit severity on there. I'm running a plasmonic leech, which at the minute, it actually pairs up with the Mako shield, which I've not actually got on this time. If you have the Mako shield on, you actually get a little bit of an increase with it, because it's bugged out at the minute. I've also got a science plasma generating weapon signature nullifier, the EPG, just to boost my exotic particle generation. I'm running the universal timeline stabilizer, just to give me a bit of increase on the bridge officer capture ability recharge times, cuts them down slightly. And the polymorphic probe array, again for the 25% antiproton damage increase on that. I'm also running a tactical console from the fleet spires, the vulnerability locator, two of, which gives you a 31.9% antiproton damage increase and a 1.6 crit chance. I've got two of them, plus then I've got two of the exploiters, which give you a boost on your antiproton again, and also this time on your crit severity. The mastery slots on it, I've only just got the ships, so I've literally just got to master level 2. You get a plus 5 accuracy rating for your first mastery unlock. Second one, you get a plus 15 crit severity. When I get to my third, I'll have a plus 2.5 crit chance and a plus 10% kinetic energy damage increase when I get to my tier 4. Stations, at the minute the stations aren't properly set up, I'm just running these at the minute. I need to just have a bit of a change round.
Security,
you don't get many options on it. You've got a universal commander, lieutenant commander here. You've got a commander tactical station, a lieutenant commander science, and a lieutenant engineering. So you've not got a very big change to them. There's not very much you can do with it. Okay, let's have a quick look at the different designs we've got with it. Okay, so my current ship, which is what I am running, is the nicor variant of it, but you can actually swap it over to a Dactylus, which is a lot shorter. Not actually, it doesn't look too bad, that one. You gain on it, or you gain some spikes on the wings. The wings will move slightly forward and the front shorter. We've also got the upgrade. So I can actually upgrade it, the hull. Which doesn't actually look that bad though. I think we'll leave it as the upgrade version. There's only one bridge currently. So let's see. I've been doing a few runs with it. It is, at the minute, not brilliant, but I've not done much with it. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go and take it on a queue and have another look at what it rules like. I'm running on advanced queues. I'm going to do gateway to Greetha, do a quick run of that, have a look, see how it manages to play on here. Okay, I will be back shortly.
Thank you.
Okay, guys, let's have a quick look. Now I've actually got into a mission map. Stats are only 22% accuracy, 11.8 crit chance, and 137.4 crit chance, 4.78, 1.631. So it's got a decent set of protection. It is only a T5U, so it's nowhere near T6 spec. But so you don't get a starship trait with it or anything like that. But as a T5 ship, it is pretty good. It's last well. Guys, that's the end of this video. I have actually got another one to do, whether I get around to it tonight or maybe tomorrow. Because I have actually just got the Wells science ship as well. I also got a breed and the Thorium Mesh Weaver as well, which is quite a fun ship. I've done a bit more on that, but I've not actually been in testing it. I've started getting some of the carrier gear for it. Yeah, it's Wells Temple science vessel. So we'll have a look at them in another video. Thanks a lot, guys. Catch you all later.